What's good, everyone? Hello and welcome into another movie reaction. If you're new to my channel, my name is Kale, and for the month of October, I decided to watch and react to all of the Ghostbusters films because I'd never seen them before and figured that would be a fun October theme. Today is movie number 3, which is the reboot from 2016. I do know that this is a female group of Ghostbusters. I only know two of them, Kristen Wiig and Melissa McCarthy. I haven't looked close enough at the poster, so I might know the other two and just don't realize that I do. I also know that this movie is not well loved by most people. So I'm very curious to see what I think of it in the end. And I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to having a fun time. So thank you so much for tuning in. I am watching the extended edition, by the way. I didn't know that there were more than two versions. Someone let me know and send me a link to the extended ones. That is the one I'm checking out today. As always, if you want to watch along with me to the whole movie, you can find that over on my Patreon. But if not, that's totally fine too. Just thank you so much for being here. And with that, let's get into the movie.
So the Aldrich Mansion is the only 19th century home in New York City preserved both inside and out. This grandfather clock was on the Titanic.
They saved an entire grandfather clock? Please.
Sir Aldrich awoke, furious, when his breakfast was not waiting for him. So he called to his servants. They had each been stabbed to death in their sleep. Gertrude Aldrich, they locked her in this basement. When a new owner moved in, they dug out her remains. No one has opened this door since then.
It's a beautiful home, though. Oh. Oh. Uh-oh. House is fucking with you now.
I gotta get out of here.
Real talk, we would all shit our pants if this was happening to us.
You idiot.
This poor man.
Dr. Roberts?
Oh,
Robert, hello.
Aaron, sweetheart.
Aaron.
I'm lecturing in the big hall today.
Darling, that's wonderful. This is what you're wearing?
Oof. Damn.
I think journals tamper with the process and ultimately hurt scientific research.
Yeah, it's like when scientists get caught up, you know, in those dumb awards. You know?
Oh, awards are massively important.
I should be going.
Hey, Simon.
Mm-hmm. We will soon be able to combine general relativity and quantum theory.
Big hop, big hop, big
hop.
But I need to speak to you about something you wrote. I'm talking about your book.
Saul's old boss.
This really does look like you.
What? No.
Yeah, that's me.
Oh, it was just a gag between a couple of friends.
The first sentence is, this is not a joke. I'm the historian at the Aldrich Mansion, and I believe it's haunted.
That book you're holding is utter nonsense. I don't even know how you got that. I thought I burned both copies.
Both.
Dr. Fillmore, hello, hi.
You're set for the final review of your tenure case on Thursday.
I love Charles Dance.
I think you're an asset to modern physics, but I would hate to see you throw it down the drain. About your clothes.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, everyone has a problem with what she's wearing.
Too sexy for academia.
I think the opposite, I think.
Abby, you promised you wouldn't.
Okay, so Melissa McCarthy is Abby.
Passion for the study of the paranormal at the Kenneth P. Higgins Institute of Science.
You didn't know that? You guys aren't that close? You didn't know that?
I hope you brought me more than one wonton.
Excuse me?
Oh.
Aaron? Abby?
You know they make smaller headphones now, right?
It's an advance in science.
You put our book online without my permission.
I don't need your permission. That book is a whole new revenue stream for me.
What about her?
And you abandoned that baby before it even learned to fly. I got one wonton.
I'd be pissed too.
You carry a lot of tension in your shoulders.
Sorry, hello?
Oh, hell yes.
Virgo, avid skier, gluten full, and 100% jazz to meet you.
Husband works with me here in the lab. She's a brilliant engineer and very loyal. Holtzman and I are really busy here actualizing what we just theorized about in our book. We're incredibly close on the hollow laser for the reverse tractor beam.
A few months ago, we spent 8 nights at the Chelsea Hotel. It's disgusting.
Is it more or less disgusting if I tell you it came from the front?
I can do it live if you want. Okay, you know what? I thought we could have an adult conversation.
Me too.
A man came to see me at my work saying his building was haunted. The Aldridge Mansion, which is obviously a joke.
They're not going to take it as one.
Exactly. Go find some ghosts?
Yes.
Oh, I kind of feel bad for Aaron.
Let's go. I'm not going with you guys.
Oh, no. Are you kidding? You were never invited. I need you out of the lab so I can lock the door.
We said let's, so.
Oh, my God. Just pull the door. Just close the door.
I'm like Aaron. I also assume that she meant, like, let's go, the three of us.
Abby, just take the book down.
But you have to introduce us to this guy at the Aldridge Mansion.
Then I will consider, maybe, taking the book down.
I love Holtzman's look or vibe.
We're looking for Ed Mulgrave.
Ed Mulgrave died 15 years ago.
Yes. That's awesome.
But that's Ed's son, Ed Jr.
Oh.
That's obviously who I meant.
Hi.
Yeah, no kidding. No kidding.
Checking the settings, we look good.
Can you tell us what it's like to walk around in those shoes all day?
It's not fun.
All right.
Also, check the
Pringles
out.
Can.
Hold your ponies.
Oh, that's a thing. Mm-hmm.
Is everything a joke to you guys? Okay, you guys put all that gooey stuff on the floor. You open the basement door. You try to freak me out.
We did not open the basement door.
Basement door is open.
The one that was heavily locked? Mm-hmm.
I didn't even know it did that.
Then definitely
an APX shift.
Yes, I mean, for sure. That's...
Guys?
We got blue light.
Good God. Class 4 apparition.
I think she wants to communicate with us.
I knew it.
Maybe?
I think you're gorgeous.
Erin Gilbert, doctor of particle physics at Columbia. Oh,
Jesus Christ. Oh my God.
Yes! She's getting away, come on!
Where'd it go?
She's gone.
We saw ghosts. Yeah.
And you got slimed.
We were crazy!
Oh.
Yay, now we're made up, hopefully.
Ghosts are real! I believe in ghosts because I just saw one, they're real!
Who is that?
Girl, you can't.
When we give someone tenure, they represent this institution.
So people can't have hobbies? Lame.
Dr. Gibbons, I didn't get fired, even though I have the old plant.
Oh, girl. Just be quiet.
Well, I hope you're happy. That video you posted got me fired.
So we definitely have not made up yet.
Ain't no bitches gonna hunt no ghosts.
Oh, no. This woman is describing a class 3 haunting in her house. She can't just move. She can call the police. Friends, who's she gonna call?
Ghost jumpers! Tonight, the ghost jumpers.
Ghost jumpers?
It's because of stuff like this that makes it impossible for us to do our real work.
Erin, this is what we have dreamed about since we were little kids.
Yeah, chase your dream.
I just honestly didn't realize your department still existed.
Come on, ghosts? I will not let the 12-year reputation of this fine institution be besmirched by you.
Oh my gosh, the institutions.
I think it might be a ghost. Oh, no, it's not. It's just a bird.
This is incredibly immature.
I agree. I did like that last one, though.
We can become the first scientists to prove the existence of the paranormal. All we have to do is find an entity and capture it and bring...
There's the Erin I remember. Welcome back.
Thank you.
I am excited for past Erin to come back out and shine. The version of the Erin that wrote that book.
When the fourth cataclysm begins, laborers such as yourself will be among the last led to the butchery. Make the most of your extra time.
You have a good day with your crazy ass.
I'd be stepping away if it were me. It's sparking and smoking.
Hey, you're not supposed to be down here, man.
That's exactly why you don't get close.
What is that?
the sweet tail.
Creepy.
Exquisite.
That's one way to describe it.
You have been bullied your entire life. Now you will be the bully. Trust in your abilities.
No, that's not what you do. You don't become a bully just because you were bullied.
And the universe shall bend before your will.
Charge the lines. Create the vortex. Break the barrier.
Men is interesting.
What do you think?
That's it?
Let's go see your new home.
Hey. Nice.
Look at this. Look at it.
Be me if I was in this firehouse.
The rent is $21,000 a month.
Fuck you.
Damn.
Excuse me. I'm sorry.
That'd be my response.
Are you offended by the smell of Chinese food?
You know what?
That's water. She is probably going to be my favorite by the end. She's giving her same like weird Barbie energy in this movie that she had in Barbie.
If you see something, say something.
That's very vague.
It's catchy. It's good.
Yeah,
well,
I think it
might be the anti-terrorism slogan.
That too.
I guess now we know why so many people are calling about suspicious looking bags.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Got to be more specific.
Hey, I'm here about the receptionist.
Oh, Chris Hemsworth. Holy shit.
You're hired.
Oh my God, he's adorable looking. Hello. I love his vibe.
There's something strange in the Oh.
Yeah, that's a better slogan. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Hey, Kevin. Oh, that's a manly name.
Girl, what?
You know, are you seeing anyone right now?
Girl.
What have you been doing with your whole life?
Great question.
Lots of different jobs. I did the the acting.
They're not.
Would it be okay if I bring my cat to work sometimes? He has major anxiety problems.
But I have a pretty severe cat allergy.
Oh, I don't have a cat. He's a dog.
Your dog's name is Mike. Last name Hat.
Well, his full name is Michael.
I was wondering why the subtitles were. Because I heard my cat.
Kevin dabbles in web design, and I asked him to throw together maybe a couple of logos. Uh-huh. Pull it out.
Oh.
But like a lawsuit waiting to happen.
I would agree with that.
Okay, so what do you think of that?
I'm going to pass.
Oh, I think that's already a thing.
That's one of my favorites.
I think you might have made a mistake. I don't think that one's for us.
No, I just thought the floating hot dog implies that a ghost is holding it.
Okay.
As much as I would like to have him here to look at, I don't find him attractive.
Aaron, we need help around here.
I think Holtzman is into him.
God, that's loud, huh?
You got the job.
Welcome aboard.
Cool. Can I bring my suitcases up?
Suitcases?
Hi, ma'am. If you're waiting for takeout, you should really wait downstairs.
Oh, and the magazine was here, so I...
No, she needs your help.
Have you seen a class 4 semi-anchored entity anywhere in the vicinity?
Have you seen a ghost down here?
Okay, that's clear.
Yeah, just say ghost. People know what ghosts are.
Stop painting.
I'm so sorry.
I don't like this on my wall.
You don't want it here anymore?
I don't want this ghost on my
wall. No ghosts. No ghosts allowed.
You know what? You know
right?
Oh, is this going to be the logo? This is going to be the logo, isn't it?
Am I on crack, or is that a good logo?
Yep. Sure is.
Definitely got something over here. Look at, is that, what is that, a bird?
That's where I saw that weird sparking thing.
What was it?
Baby, if I knew.
You're mouthy. I like that.
Me too. I like Patty.
The eyes.
All right, Holtzman, now's not the time to be messing with
no.
You. Oh, premature. Can I get some illumination on this subject?
Yeah, I can put some light on that.
Oh, boy. Holtzman?
Yup.
Power us up, because okay. We are taking this pretty boy back to the lab.
This pretty boy, mm-hmm.
Why am I operating the untested nuclear laser?
You have the longest arms. This is just a little bit of grounding so you don't die immediately.
Do you know your iron level?
Mm-mm. It's fine.
You have done this before, right?
No. First time. Try again. Try again. Try again.
That's the train. We gotta move.
we're cutting this so close. Always.
Oh God, the collar!
Well,
we need more juice. We need to be more mobile. I know what to do.
I almost got killed.
It was so awesome.
It was awesome.
Everyone thinks this video is fake. Look at these comments. We have to bring a ghost back to this lab and document it, you guys. I mean, this stuff is real. We have to be able to prove it.
Did you get sugar in it this time?
I hate coffee.
Waste. Can we just pretend that didn't happen?
You know what? I just can't.
What was that weird thing that guy said to the lady from the subway?
Fourth cataclysm.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hi.
Man, what they gonna do, make a fifth one? I'm joining the club.
Well, it's not really it. Sorry. Kevin. Hi, can you answer the phone, please?
I can't. It's in the fish tank.
No, the one on the desk that's ringing.
Slow down. What?
Brother.
I was just not into that conversation.
Brother.
Kevin. I'm really gonna need you to try a little harder.
I'm gonna take off, though. I'm in a hide-and-seek tournament, and we are in the semis.
Did y'all hire that big dumb dude?
Bye!
Man.
Yes, solely on the basis that he's cute, and nothing else.
And you guys know a lot about this science stuff, but I know New York. I can borrow a car from my uncle, and y'all won't have to lug all this heavy equipment around.
Welcome to the team. Honestly, I think Patty actually might be my favorite by the end.
You get a car, and you get a car!
You didn't disclose that the vehicle was going to be a hearse.
I'm sorry.
A hearse has space, at least. And a hearse is actually appropriate for what they do.
Maintenance man.
Mrs. Potter, how may I help you?
Perhaps you can tell me what in God's name this is.
The walls will ooze green slime.
This is nothing more than some leakage from our air conditioning.
Well, I think it's touched my skin and it's given me a rash.
Oh, yep.
Yes, I'm afraid there is some redness in here.
Is it very bad?
No, whoever is responsible for this will be flogged within an inch of their life and then left in the street to die like a pig.
That's harsh.
I know everyone is anxious, but we have to be patient. Who thought it would be funny to put Earl in that old lady's back?
He's like their dad.
Based on the results of the subway field test,
I remember.
I added a booster using microfabricated radio frequency quadrupoles.
Thanks. Plus Holtz's hollow beam to this baby, and voila, we got a ghost in there.
Woo! Slap me. Okay.
I like that Aaron is in a hoodie and jeans. I didn't mind the other outfits, but
that little asshole over there is the target.
And here we go!
Oh, jeez.
I'll make some adjustments.
It's exciting, Gator.
Rock Revenge Fest.
Ozzy rocks! Woo!
Yeah! This world cannot be cleansed fast enough.
So how did the two of you guys meet?
Abby transferred to my high school junior year.
We started telling ghost stories, and we just kind of bonded. Wait. And all the other kids were, you know, getting drunk, and we're like, that's stupid.
Plus, we weren't invited to any party. When I was 8 years old, a mean old lady that lived next door died. That night, I woke up and she was standing at the foot of my bed. She did that every night for almost a year.
That's terrifying.
I had to go to therapy for years. The kids at school found out and they would laugh at me and call me ghost girl. Abby was the only person who believed me.
I was in a box when we were moving.
Oh, no.
Adorable.
I kind of wish I could have seen it, man.
You might just get your wish,
no
Patty.
No way.
Wait, you have it?
Damn, I wish I hadn't wished that. Lord have mercy.
Still remember? Oh, I love Kevin in the back, just like bobbing his head.
Normal is normal and a valid science.
Thank you for requesting.
I love that they both remember this. I wish I remembered. Actually, there is one presentation I remember.
A local team of paranormal investigators released a video of a proclaimed ghost. What do we think of these Ghostbusters? Are they to be taken seriously?
And Ghostbusters, sort of that is not our name. They can't just make up a name and just call us.
But it's cool, though. So you're going to use it.
Dr. Heiss, you're a highly regarded scientific authority. Your credentials are impeccable.
Thank you, Pat.
If...
Aww. Hey, Belle.
Is this for real?
Hell no.
Funny.
Physical results. That's what we believe in.
Yes, we do.
Breach.
Kevin, answer that phone.
Can you answer the phone that's ringing?
Buddy.
Please?
Yes, I can, boss.
Cool. See ya.
Hey, guys, which one of these makes me look more like a doctor? The Stonebrook Theater? There's a goat on the loose.
Okay.
How do you just completely ignore my calls?
Ignore you?
Yeah.
You just stood there during the most humiliating moment of my life.
Is that her boyfriend?
Was.
Now everyone's saying you're some sort of crazy ghost hunter.
We stalk them, and we are very close to trapping one soon. And then we will study it.
I think he's mechanical from, like, the ribcage down.
No!
I know how that guy dances.
How's he dance?
Like...
I bet you.
He did. No!
Get enough booze in him, and he'll probably dance like how Patty's dancing right now.
Oh! Look at that beauty!
Woo! Looking good.
What did you do to my uncle's hair?
It looks fine.
Aaron, we have to. This is not funny. Please get me.
If anyone ever did this to me, I would just immediately turn around and walk away. Sorry, don't have time for that bullshit. This version's not nearly as good as the original. I see shadows all on my wall. Man, he must be big and tall. Love it. Holtzman looks the best.
Are you the Ghostbusters?
Actually, we're the conductors of the metaphysical.
Yes.
You're the Ghostbusters. Stop trying to make conductors of metaphysical blah, blah, blah happen. It's not gonna happen.
Let's split up, and if you see anything, get on the walkie.
Separate them in a No. No. That was all I needed to hear to go no. There you go. One of the sparky thingies.
I just thought this was going to be like a book club. Play some Stevie Nicks albums, you know. Because I'm telling you right now, if I see two twins from The Shining.
I would too. I might rewatch The Shining this Halloween because I haven't seen the movie since I reacted to it on the channel. All that time ago.
But I tell you what, everybody was a lie.
Oh, that's creepy. Oh, that's creepy.
Was that there before? Please do not answer.
Was not. Oh, gosh.
Hi.
It's full paranormal.
Let's light him up.
The hell was that? From a visual effects standpoint, this movie already has me excited for the next two.
This music is so terrible, it's making them more angry. Play something gentle!
You're at a metal show, girl. Not gonna get much gentle.
We are the kings of us!
That's us! Come on, move to the left! Oh, ooh, watch the rings.
No.
Okay, so I don't know if it was a race thing or a lady thing. Don't want to piss off the ghost. Going back to my booth at the MTA. So let me know if you need some Metro cards. Because I am...
Jeez.
Oh, you gonna get in there!
I forgot to tell you, don't let your be...
Yeah, don't cross the streams.
What? Why? It's too much power.
Oh, no, but
and don't look into it.
Erin doing great. Abby doing great. Patty, try a little harder.
Perfect. Good job.
Did we just catch a ghost?
Y'all did.
We put a ghost in a bar!
You want some more?
Wankers. Black Sabbath did that shit in 74.
I was wondering if he was actually going to make an appearance. Oh, that's fab.
Charge the lines, create the vortex, break the barrier.
I don't know how I feel about this man. I won't lie. Up in here, y'all gonna make me go all out. Up in here.
This is Smartin Christ here to see you.
Smartin Christ. Are you saying Martin Heist? Dr. Martin Heist, no. The famed scientist and paranormal debunker. He's in this building right now?
Yeah, that guy.
Okay, you tell him that we're not here.
Okay, I didn't think we would actually see him again.
Perfect time. We were just
I love his vibe. The fit is fantastic.
Why are you pretending to catch ghosts?
We successfully trapped a class 3 vapor.
There is a ghost inside that thermos?
Booyah. Emphasis on the boo.
Well, I would love to see that.
That's not gonna happen.
How's that for my timing? I come, you've caught a ghost, I can't see it.
It sounds crazy.
Did nobody have their phones out at that concert filming the trapping of the ghost in 2016?
I'm going to show it to you then. How about that?
Me, why are you doing this?
Because he doesn't believe us.
Who cares if you impress him?
Oh, God, you two are something. Atta girl! Casper?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
He wasn't really Ghostbusters material.
Who threw him out the window?
He was the Ghostbusters material.
That's it. And then we were all dancing at a summer camp in the Catskills. And then we sat down, and he was behind me, and we made a vase.
I combined a couple of Swayze movies. You know what was a good one? Roadhouse.
I love it.
I haven't seen Roadhouse yet.
Point Break. Come on, at the end with a big wave.
Point Break's on the channel, if you guys are interested. Collabed with EOM Reacts on that one. I want to see Roadhouse, though. Both versions, the new one and the original.
We know you're not frauds, because we have been monitoring this situation quite closely.
Agents Hawkins and Rourke are with Homeland Security.
We believe that someone is creating a device that attracts and amplifies paranormal activity.
I really appreciate it, but it's time to knock it off.
These gentlemen are on it. Let the government do their work.
No thanks.
Well, if it's a crime to look good, guilty as charged.
Other than that, I feel like we keep a very low profile.
You drive a hearse with a ghost on it, and you use a distinctly un-American sounding siren.
We are going to have to make the public believe that you are frauds.
The human brain, you know, it can only handle so much.
The human brain can only handle so much. There's a lot of shit in the world. This wouldn't even be the worst of everyone. This wouldn't even be close to the worst of everyone's problems.
New Mexico reports a UFO encounter. The crew of the SS Rangmadon dies mysteriously. The entire town of Langville, Montana goes missing.
That's Wanda.
Thank you all so much for coming.
Call this number if you have any more info.
Unlock it.
Okay, wait,
unlock
wait, hold
it.
On.
You think they got genitals in there, or is it more of a Ken doll situation?
It's so funny that she has that line in this movie, and then a fairly similar line in Barbie. Ooh.
This puppy I like to call a ghost chipper.
You truly scare me. I just want to let you know that.
Oh, it's like Mardi Gras in there.
Just give it a punch, it's motion activated.
No, that is a deadly high five.
These women are fake.
Oh! Oh, my favorite acid.
Okay, I'll get it.
Careful.
I like this look.
What was that thing that threw that man out the window the other day?
Kevin, it was a ghost.
A ghost?
Do you not know what goes on here?
No.
We sell the restaurant. Guys, we have no customers anyway.
Kevin, this man really just sits at that desk on the computer all day and does nothing.
Who cares what anybody else is saying about us? We know what we're doing. I mean, all morning I've been reading about this stuff.
Yeah, there's going to be people that totally believe you and support you and will let you know.
Where did we find the first device?
At the subway, right here.
Okay. What do those look like to you?
Oh, it's an X. Touching other little X's.
It's a hidden network of energy lines that run across the Earth.
He's using the devices to charge the ley lines. He's creating a vortex.
If he gets one of his machines in there, he's going to be able to rip a hole right through that barrier.
Letting whatever's on this plane come crashing down on this plane.
This is the dude that was at the subway that was talking about the cataclysms. This is him.
It's always the sad, pale ones.
Sweet. Let's do it. I didn't know that there could be a character that Chris Hemsworth plays that is dumber than the dumbest version of Thor. This movie has it. I do think that Chris does a good job at playing that kind of personality, though.
Well, I'm terribly sorry that you have a draft in your room. Why don't you hold while I connect you to someone who might care?
Hi.
What do you want?
Where's your janitor?
Oh, that nut job. What has he done? I don't want to know. And get him out.
Love it. My gosh.
Hey, stop right there! Shut it down!
He's not just going to do that because he yelled it.
I see things that no one else does. I am rewarded with nothing but scorn and mockery.
Really? I am not the only one seeking revenge.
Souls who see the world as it truly is, as garbage. Children will be pestered limb from limb in front of their own parents. The parents will be pestered in half.
That's a different definition of pestered than what I was thinking.
Let's get these barriers destroyed, shall we?
Wait, Rowan, I get it. You don't like people. I mean, wonderful things that are... that are worth living for. You got soup.
As long as it's not watery.
Oh God, I can only think of soup.
Yep, soups and salads, guys.
Bye.
What the fuck?
It's a weird move.
Oh, he dead. That's a dead man.
Okay, see if you can shut that thing down.
Well, are we good?
Well, he's not, but yeah, we're okay.
Basically, like we're both using the same science.
I think I know why. Look what Mr. Cuckoo Pants has been reading.
Oh. Fun.
The mayor thanks you, of course, privately, so don't tell anyone.
These gentlemen here will get you out of here, okay? So we just are gonna fake arrest you now. Oh, and we towed your car. Real tow, not fake tow.
Oh, no.
It was just another publicity stunt by these incredibly sad and lonely women.
I hate it. They'll be back.
How does it feel wasting taxpayer money and government resources with your pranks?
Why don't you go back to your mother's basement where you live?
Yeah, I plan to after this. I talked to somebody you went to school with.
Aw, leave us alone.
He's too pasty to fight!
Aaron, you're making this look bad right now!
Aaron, come on, let it go!
They should put you back in therapy, you freak. Oh! Oh, damn!
Nosebusters. Oh, dear.
Oh, no, no.
It's unfortunate that we have these former ties with Miss Gilbert.
Oh, dear.
Miss Gilbert's association with the Kenneth P. Higgins Institute is a blight on this university. But I have an album dropping in 2 weeks.
Oh, my gosh. I don't like this man.
So, Abby, I've been doing a lot of thinking, and...
I like this look, too.
Congratulations.
I just think I like everything that Chris wears.
God. I don't have time to try to explain why that's not going to happen.
Thought they would have been happy about that.
Not going to lie, I want to read that book. Oh. The fourth cataclysm. I will lead them all.
You didn't think I was gone when there's so much left to do, did you, Abby? It's brilliant,
oh,
really.
No thanks.
I apologize. That looks nastier than I intended.
Oh, gosh. This is gross.
When Rowan killed himself, it was just the next step in his plan.
Abby.
Hello, Jillian.
Are you okay?
You're quite well.
She noticed immediately the vibes are off.
What are you doing? Hey! Wait a minute! No! Man, are y'all playing? Because this ain't funny, man!
Look at the view.
Oh my God, no!
Goodbye! Ah! Ah, I got you, baby! I got you!
Hi, Patty.
Ew. Need a little bitch slap, that's all.
Check it out. Hey, listen, I figured you're gonna need my help.
That's so cute.
I was born to be a Ghostbuster, all right? Nothing's gonna stop me.
Oh, no. Weirdly, though, I'm excited for this version of Kevin.
This guy knows how to ride a motorcycle.
Rowan, not Kevin!
Yeah, he does.
You have to evacuate the city.
Never say that word.
You've shut down the power to the whole city. Okay, that's a dumpster, but the undead are still arriving.
The rumble was much louder than that.
Please don't be like the mayor in Jaws.
Jaws reaction on the channel. Check it out if you missed it.
Man, nobody heard of Clark Kent's Strip-O-Gram.
Clark Kent.
Oh, I definitely should have worked out more.
I like this guy more when Rowan is inside of him. Kind of love how that looks, though. Damn. Yeah, that looks terrifying. Oh my gosh, not the rats. Hi.
Yeah, that's like one more block south than I want to go.
Those are actual ghosts flying around.
Class 5 floating vapors, nothing to worry about.
No, it's important. Don't you see what's happening?
I don't go to Chinatown. I don't drive wackos, and I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
Love it. The cameos are fun. I enjoy the cameos. Oh no. Oh no.
My uncle is gonna be pissed.
Oh, don't shoot. The equipment on top of that is basically a nuclear reactor.
What?
Okay, I vote we don't shoot at that.
Well, we just gave a ghost a nuke. We should probably run.
If the car means so much to you, do never, ever leave the keys in it. Oh, yeah, there it is.
You guys, this is exactly how I pictured my death.
Excellent. Thanks, Abby.
I think the balloon popped in my ear.
Let's go save this city and get our terrible receptionist back.
Who's the flying beefcake?
Why, though? Why would the bad guy do this? It's okay, I don't mind seeing Chris Hemsworth dance.
Welcome to the glory days of New York City.
Okay, power up!
Halsey, get on, get out!
Oh, not this thing again.
And this is what you get for sitting on me!
No, Patty!
Say hello to my little...
I like that one. Okay. It's my favorite moment so far. And the music, the theme. Let's see at her moment.
Oh, God. It feels like the slime is after me, personally. Who are you?
Oh, I'm Frank.
Get out of here!
Please sit.
Don't mind if I do.
He's all yours.
Oh, good catch-ish.
Nobody hurts Kevin, man! Nobody hurts Kevin!
I know he's dumb as a box of rocks, and I know he's as heavy as one. What's he made out of?
You couldn't tell he was heavy just by looking at him? The man is tall and has muscles.
Oh, guys, he's really going for it.
Good lord. Burning him seems to work. Let's keep doing that.
We gotta cross the streams.
Wait. You mean that?
Fire him up! We still don't have enough power to reverse it!
Yeah.
You are a genius, Patty.
I'm a Ghostbuster.
Yes, you are. Goodbye, car.
The portal's closing!
Abby, hang on!
Grab her. There we go.
I wasn't gonna leave you twice.
Okay, let's get out of this place. Yep. What happened to their hair? Oh, cool. I like how suddenly it's daytime.
Oh my god!
Oh my gosh, they both look great with white hair. I love it.
What year is it?
It's 2040.
What?
Oh, when I was looking for you guys, I looked in that deli over there.
You stopped in to get a sandwich?
Look, we're splitting hairs. Point is, the Ghostbusters are back together again.
You can't hate them.
The government trying to claim the event wasn't supernatural.
Well, now I know how Batman feels. To me, the purpose of life is to love, and to love is what you have shown me.
Aw. Cute.
You know, we need to be better prepared. Whatever you need going forward. Anything? Anything.
Hell yeah!
Is this what I think? Yeah! Hell yes. Oh, hey.
Patty's uncle.
Where's the car?
It's on the other side.
In Jersey?
No.
You know what? We should probably let them just work this out.
Fun. Yeah.
I'm just looking for a reasonable rate.
Ghostbusters, please give a detailed description of your apparition.
Hey, look at him.
Working on some kind of next level stuff. Case in point.
Oh.
It catches ghosts and it transports them somewhere else. I don't know where. Hi. Hello. Sorry, I didn't know anyone else was.
Hey.
I forgot to introduce. This is my mentor, Dr. Rebecca Gorin.
This is reckless, Julian.
Aw, cute.
I call it the Nutcracker. Oh, because it crushes the ghost. No, it's for walnuts.
I heard something really weird. What's Zool?
All right, y'all. There was a half-decent movie somewhere in here. I'm not sure where it was. It was buried and in hiding. It's kind of disappointing because I really did want to enjoy this movie. But the best way that I can describe this movie is that it was a two-hour-plus long SNL sketch of Ghostbusters instead of being like a properly rebooted Ghostbusters film that could be somewhat on par with the first two films. Like, that's my biggest takeaway. And here's the thing, I like SNL humor, but I like it in the way that SNL humor is delivered to us, which is in bite-sized sketches. When you take SNL humor and you throw it into a runtime like this, and yes, I made it worse by watching the extended edition, but when you do that, it just drags on. And a lot of the humor in this really dragged, and they sat with it for a while, and it was just, it started to become very tiring after a while. And I'm disappointed by it because I really love Kristen Wiig, Melissa McCarthy, and Kate McKinnon. Those three, I've belly laughed to so much of their SNL humor and skits in the past. Leslie Jones, I didn't recognize her, but I guarantee I've probably watched her as well on SNL. So you've got four incredibly talented female comedians and just, I don't know, a script that for me just didn't work because the comedy just felt way too try-hard for something like this. And like, I think that SNL humor in general is very try-hard, but I think the biggest difference is that they're very bite-sized, and this was not. And especially comparing the comedy to the first two Ghostbusters movies, like, the reason why those two worked so well for me is because the characters were so different from one another. You had, like, Peter Venkman that was delivering most of the humor out of the four. Like, the other three definitely had their humorous moments, but I think to compare to the women, to me, it felt like all four of these ladies were in this, like, secret competition to try and be the funniest one in the group, because all four of them were constant with their humor and the delivery and the lines, and it just felt so much by the end. Like, it just felt like too much. Each of them did have their moments, and yes, there were moments where I laughed, but for the most part, it just felt like too much. Whereas the first two Ghostbusters movies, the script at least just made the humor feel so much more natural, especially when you consider like the characters themselves, right? So that's like my biggest takeaway and why I don't love this movie nearly as much as the first two. And I don't love this movie at all. I doubt I would ever rewatch this, which in saying that, you know what I really want to do? I really want to rewatch Bridesmaids because I haven't watched that movie in many years. When it first came out, I loved it, but I know that I've changed and I feel like the me of today would just probably feel exhausted by Bridesmaids as well. So maybe I will do that soon. Maybe I'll give that one a rewatch. The villain in this film is very forgettable. And listen, like, the stories in the first two Ghostbusters, I was just like kind of whatever about, but at least those villains are somewhat memorable. The guy in this movie was not at all. And Chris Hemsworth, let's chat about him real quick. He is so good at playing such a dumb person. So I definitely give him props for that. But I wished that I could have enjoyed his character a lot more, but kind of the same issue as everything else, just the comedy just felt very tiring by the end. So it was really hard for me to fully enjoy his performance and his character. Things I did enjoy about this movie though, the visual effects were really fun and have me very excited for the next two movies because of that, because, you know, the technology has gotten way better since the 80s. So I cannot wait to see what they do visually in the next two Ghostbusters movies. And another fun thing about this film was the cameos, of course. I wasn't actually expecting that. So it was a pleasant surprise to see Bill and Ernie and Dan and Sigourney and Annie all showing up. I loved seeing all of them. So that was fun. So yeah, overall, this movie was pretty mediocre. I think I definitely understand why a lot of people just say to skip over it, but I am not that kind of person. I don't skip. So here we are. I watched it. That was my review, and I really don't know that I have anything else left to say. I am, however, looking forward to going to Letterboxd to see what some other people have to say. 3 stars. The scariest part of this movie was that Fall Out Boy theme song. Was that Fall Out Boy? I didn't even realize. But yeah, it wasn't very good. 4.5 stars. I was going to give this a 4-star review, but then I saw Kate McKinnon again and gave in to the lick. Yes, that lick moment was pretty funny. Not gonna lie, I actually don't know who my favorite is between Patty and, how do I already forget her name? I'm terrible. Kate's character. I'm terrible. How do I already... I think that is proof that I found this movie mediocre when I can't even... I remember her first name was Jillian. Why can I not remember her last name? Something man. H something man. I'm terrible. I'm sorry. Yes. Okay. 2-star review. I chuckled a couple of times, but this is just not a very funny movie, which is a shame because I've seen this cast and this director be funny before. I think that what really worked about the original's humor is that it was very dry and deadpan. This movie's humor is very loud and there's very little breathing time between jokes, and a lot of it is just movie references. There's no atmosphere or grittiness or sense of awe, which is something the original had a surprising amount of. It's hard to recapture the magic of the original Ghostbusters. Not even the same cast could recapture it with the sequel. So the fact that it's trying a different tone and style is understandable. Just didn't really work in the end. The fact that such a mediocre movie that's very far from being the worst thing in the world created so much controversy still shocks me. That truly was humanity at its most pathetic. Yes, yes, women leads. Burn everything. We hate it by default because women. With that, it is now that time of the video where I turn it to you and I ask you to leave your comments down below about this Ghostbusters reboot. Let me know all of your thoughts. If you're someone that loves this movie especially, definitely comment below because I like hearing about when people love a movie that I don't really care for. Just like when I really enjoy a movie, I do like hearing why people don't. So leave your thoughts down below. I'm very excited to read your comments. And the next two Ghostbusters are coming up next in the weeks to come. We'll see you back here for that. And if you're not yet subscribed to the channel, please click here to do so. And if you want to watch something else of mine, click on over here. And we'll see you next time. Take care.